God is good all the time. The word says, seek ye the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all things will be added to you. All things will be added to you. Not taken away, but added. You know, one of the words that came for the 2017 was called explosure. Strange word. It actually is in a dictionary, Urban Dictionary. Explosure. It was a word that flew out of my mouth, and I figured I better find out what's coming out of my mouth. And the word said, the Lord said explosure. The word explosure is explosure or exposure with the magnitude of an explosion. Explosure is exposure with the magnitude of an explosion. Indescribably massive amount of exposure. That's pretty phenomenal. We already know that it started. Amen. One of the things that the Lord put on my heart for the word of 2017, which he gives a word every year for us, he says, vengeance is mine, says the Lord, and I will repay those that reproach my people. Though it may seem subtle, its effects are everlasting. Explosure is my name for 2017, to expose darkness in unusual ways that will bring forth ripple effects of repentance and righteousness. I am the father of pure light, and I'm close to those who know the meaning of my name and covet my promises. I will shield my righteous one and expose my rebellious ones. Those who call on my name, but don't know me. Only those that know me are as their shepherd will follow me. And I will lead them into prosperity, health, and the promised land. Shame will cover many and lies will excel. But my truth will overcome and my presence will bring protection. Explosure is my name as I release the multiple double portions to my covenant keepers. Many will see me, but they will not recognize me. I will cause a shift in the earth, atmosphere, and heavenlies. Birth pangs will ripple through all dimensions, and I will vindicate my righteous ones. Events will move quickly, and many will forget my conviction. Those who run from me will be reserved for my wrath. And those who run to me, I will pardon. The stage is set, the nets are filling, and hell is enlargening. The year of the sword of 2016 will continue by my wind, and 2017 will be used to peel back the evil and the veil of deception. The wind will expose the shame of evil, but will carry my righteous away to the next level of perfection. I have not forgotten you, says the Lord. Please do not forget me. I will release the broom and dustpan to clean up the ashes of destruction left by my refining fire. And I will unite my people for battle as the commander of the armies. Victory is mine. This year will be a year of suddenlies and take many by surprise because your enemy knows he has a short time. He will advance his strategies and unite many nations who come against my people in Israel. I have placed the resistance to his cause for a short time that the world may see my hand because they refuse to seek my face. We have entered a dangerous time and glorious time. Do not waver or be misled, for I will come as a thief in the night. Hold fast to my promises and my will. Assemble, assemble, assemble. There is victory in unity, says the Lord. And we have a copy of these, and you may take them with you. One of the words that came for me today to express is the Lord is talking about things that he's getting ready to do. You know, there's a purifying stage that he brings us through. The word calls those who are covenant keepers and those who are close to him and really know him, the undefiled. Everyone say, the undefiled. The undefiled. Turn to Matthew 5, please. Matthew chapter 5. Everyone say, I'm one of those among the undefiled. You better be. In Matthew chapter 5 and verse 1, and seeing the multitudes, Jesus went up on a mountain, and when he was seated, his disciples came to him, and he opened his mouth and taught them, saying, blessed, everyone say blessed, are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who thirst and hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. Some people wonder why they're not getting filled. It's because they don't thirst and hunger for righteousness. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. And blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are you when they revile and persecute you and say all kinds of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven. For so they persecuted the prophets who were before you. You are the salt of the earth. But if the salt loses its flavor, how shall it be seasoned? It is then good for nothing, but thrown out and trampled underfoot by men. You are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hidden. Nor do they light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a lampstand, and it gives light to all who are in that house. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. Blessed. See, when you're undefiled, you are considered blessed. Blessed are the salt and the light. In other words, this is the character of Christ expressing his divine nature. We are to express his divine nature. Go to Matthew 11. The undefiled. Hallelujah. In verse 6, please. What does it say? Blessed is he who is not what? Offended because of me. Blessed is he who is not offended. That's powerful. People get offended because they're still fighting for their lives. They're just saying, my flesh is bigger than yours, that's all. Matthew 13. Matthew 13 and verse 11. Is everybody there? Let's speak it together. And Jesus answered and said to them, because it has been given to you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, but to them it has not been given. For whoever has, to him more will be given, and he will have abundance. But whoever does not have, even what he has will be what? Taken away. Therefore I speak to them in parables, because seeing they do not see, and hearing they do not hear, nor do they understand. And in them the prophecy of Isaiah is fulfilled, which says, hearing you will hear and shall not understand, and seeing you will see and not perceive. For the hearts of this people have grown dull. Their ears are hard of hearing, and their eyes they have closed, lest they should see with their eyes and hear with their ears, lest they should what? Understand with their hearts and do what? Turn, which is repent, so that I should what? Heal them. But what? Blessed are your eyes, for they see, and your ears, for they hear. For surely I say to you that many prophets and righteous men desire to see what you see and did not see it, and hear what you hear and did not hear it. We are blessed by what we see and what we hear. Blessed are those who hear and see. See, there's a difference between listening. There's a lot of people that listen and say, yeah. But those who hear put it to work. They put it to effect. They practice it. If you hear it, you really practice it. Because hearing causes you to increase in faith. So there's a lot, there are many individuals that just come and listen but don't hear. And that's what he's talking about. He said there's many that can see it but don't see it. In Matthew 24. But blessed are those who hear and see spiritually. Matthew 24. Praise God. Everybody there? Let's speak it together, please. Who then is faithful and wise servant, whom his master made ruler over his household to give them food in due season? Blessed, everyone say blessed, is that servant whom his master, when he comes, will what? Find him doing, practicing, hearing. Amen? Blessed. Assuredly, I say to you that he will make him ruler over all of his goods. But if that evil servant says in his heart, my master is delaying his coming, and begins to beat his fellow servants and eat and drink with the drunkards, the master of that servant will come on a day when he is not looking for him, in an hour that he may not be aware of it, and will cut him in two and appoint his portion with the hypocrites. There shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth. But blessed who are obedient servants. Psalm 119. In verse 1, blessed. When you are blessed, you not only have favor, but you have heaven behind you, backing you. Amen? Psalm 119 and verse 1, let's speak it. Blessed are the what?
Defiled.
Undefiled. This is the conclusion, isn't it? To be undefiled means that you will be blessed. But if you're not, does everybody get it? If you're not undefiled, how can you be blessed? Because when people are defiled, it leaves access for the enemy to come to steal, kill, and destroy. Blessed are the undefiled in the way who what? Walk in the law of the Lord or the command. Blessed are those who what? Keep his testimonies. Who do what? Seek him with a what? Whole heart. People wonder why. How come God's not doing this for me? Well, seek him with all your heart. Quit having a relationship which is surface level. Go deep. Verse 3. They also do no iniquity. They walk with his ways, in his ways. You commanded us to keep your precepts diligently. Oh, that my ways were directed to keep your statutes. Then I would not be ashamed when I look into all your commandments. I will praise you with uprightness of heart. When I what? Learn your righteous judgments. See, freedom is what? Learned. I will keep your statutes. Oh, do not forsake me utterly. So blessed are the undefiled. In James chapter 1, in verse 12, blessed. Is everybody there? Let's speak it. Blessed is the man who what? Endures temptation. For when he has been approved, he will receive the crown of life, which the Lord has promised to those who love him. Blessed are those who endure, who are not taken out, and who overcome temptations. Verse 26. If any of you among you thinks he's what? Religious, and doesn't bridle his tongue, but deceives his own heart, this one's religion is useless. Pure and undefiled religion before God and the Father is this, to visit orphans and widows in their trouble and keep what? oneself unspotted from the world. That's what keeps you undefiled. Powerful. In 1 Peter chapter 1. Blessed are the undefiled. In verse 3. Is everybody there? 1 Peter chapter 1 and verse 3. It says, blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who according to his abundant mercy has begotten us again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. To a what? An inheritance indecorruptible and what? Undefiled. And that does not fade away, reserved in heaven for who? You, and who are kept by the power of God through faith for salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time. Kept by the what? Power of God. The undefiled are kept by the power of God, not by self, because you can't keep you. That's why it's important to have a relationship with the Holy Spirit. Amen. Ephesians chapter 5. Hallelujah. Ephesians 5:25. Let's speak it together. Husbands, love your wives just as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for her, that he might what? Sanctify her and cleanse her with the washing of the water by the what? Word. You know it's a husband's responsibility to wash the wife with the word? That he might what? Present her to himself a glorious church, not having spot or what? Wrinkle. Why? Because then they're undefiled, aren't they? Or any such thing, but that she should be holy and without blemish. So husbands ought to love their own wives as their own bodies, and he who loves his wife loves himself. For no one ever hated his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it, just as the Lord does the church. For we are members of his body, of his flesh, and his bones. For this reason a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. Now he explains it. This is a what? Great mystery. But I speak concerning Christ and the church. So he was using marriage as a representation of you being married to Christ. Nevertheless, let each one of you, and particularly so, love his own wife as himself, and let the wife see that she respects her husband. So we are the wife, he is the husband. Amen. So we are to respect him, but he desires to speak his word over me and you to wash us. This is the mystery. Your marriage won't work unless you're first married to him. It's very difficult to have a marriage not being married to him. Because when things are going on, each one is still married to him. Amen? Glory. Not having spot or wrinkle. That means staying undefiled, cleansed, purified, sanctified. 1 Thessalonians 4. I think this is a wonderful way to start the new season. Blessed and undefiled. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 and verse 3. Let's speak it. For this is the will of God, your what? Sanctification. That you should abstain from sexual immorality, that each of you should know how to possess his own vessel in sanctification and honor, not in passion of lust, like the Gentiles who do not know God, that no one should take advantage of and defraud his brother in this matter, because the Lord is the avenger of all such, as we also forewarned you and testified. For God did not call us to uncleanness, but to what? To what?
Holiness.
Holiness. Therefore, he who rejects this does not reject man, but God, who has also given us his what? Holy Spirit. Why? Because without the Holy Spirit, which is the power, you cannot keep you. You must have the power on high to keep you sanctified and undefiled. It's already got it. In Romans 12. So we are to be sanctified. There is sanctification to holiness. There's holy rollers and holy dancers. Chapter 12. Romans 12, in verse 1. Let's speak it together. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a what? Living sacrifice, wholly acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service or your what? Responsibility. Can you imagine presenting a defiled body to God? People try to. Knowing that they're living a lie. See, rebellion is sin. People trying to worship God, they can worship God, but God ain't doing nothing. They keep resisting conviction. And the heart gets harder and harder. They call themselves blessed, but they're not blessed. Because only the undefiled are blessed. Verse 2. And do not be what? Conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Well, how are you going to renew your mind? Through the word. You don't read the word, you're not going to be sanctified. Because you won't have truth. You'll just move by whatever you feel. And your feelings dictate very deceptive things. Even Satan's doctrine says, do what thy feel like. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable, perfect will of God. The undefiled living, we are to be the undefiled living sacrifice to God to follow in fellowship. Has everybody got it? In other words, when you're presenting your spirit, soul, and body to the Lord as a living sacrifice, you are doing it for fellowship, for service, and for battle. For fellowship, for service, and for battle. You are offering yourself. Not only yourself, but your desires, your will, and your possessions. Everybody got it? So you offer your spirit, soul, body, and flesh, your will, desires, and possessions as a living sacrifice to him. So that you can have fellowship, service, and battle. You have offered yourself a living sacrifice, undefiled and sanctified. And when he accepts it, because he won't accept anything that's defiled. He only accepts things that are undefiled. Things begin to happen. Is everybody okay? In Titus 1. Remember, Explosure is 2017. That means many will be exposed that are defiled. Titus 1:10. Let's speak it together, please. For there are many insubordinate, which means rebellion, both idle talkers and deceivers, especially those of the circumcision, whose mouths must be stopped, who subvert whole households, teaching things which they ought not to, for the sake of dishonest gain. One of them, a prophet of their own, said, Cretans are always liars, evil beasts, lazy gluttons. This testimony is true. Therefore, rebuke them sharply, that they may be sound in faith, not giving heed to Jewish fables and commandments of men who turn from the truth. To the pure, all things are pure, but to those who are what? Defiled and unbelieving, nothing is pure. But even their mind and their conscience are defiled. Wow. They profess to know God, but in works they deny him, being abominable, disobedient, and disqualified for every good work. So we see that there's a difference between those who are pure and undefiled and those who are defiled. In Hebrews chapter 12, hallelujah. In verse 14, let's speak it. Pursue peace with all people and holiness, without which no one will see the Lord. You don't hear that spoken too many times. Looking carefully, lest anyone fall short of the grace of God, lest any root of bitterness springing up cause trouble. And by this, many become what? Defiled. They become what? Defiled. Lest there be any fornicator or profane person like Esau, who for one morsel of food sold his birthright. For you know that afterward, when he wanted to inherit the blessing, he was what? Rejected. Why? Because he was defiled. For he found no place for repentance, though he sought it diligently with tears. So he cried, but didn't turn. A lot of people cry and don't turn. Oh, hallelujah. Many become defiled, selling their birthrights for fame and fortune and selfish gain. In Jeremiah 17, verse 5. So if the undefiled is blessed, what is defiled? Cursed. A curse gives a legal right for demons to access people and come to steal, kill, and destroy. They wonder why their lives are a mess. In verse 5, thus says the Lord, what? Curses a man who what? Trusts in man or himself and makes his own flesh his strength, whose heart departs from the Lord. For he shall be like a shrub in the desert, that's pretty dry, and shall not see when good comes because he's blinded, but shall inhabit the parched places in the wilderness in a salt land which is not inhabited. That's a terrible place to inherit. But verse 7, blessed is the man who what? Trusts in the Lord and whose hope is in the Lord. For he shall be like a tree planted by the waters, which spreads out its roots by the what? River. We come alive in the river. And will not fear when heat comes, but its leaf will be green and will not be anxious. Everyone say anxious. See, anxious is nothing but fear. And will not be anxious in the year of drought, nor will cease from yielding fruit. Praise God. Blesses that person to trust in the Lord, and curses that person who trusts in man. In James chapter 3, the undefiled. Is everybody okay? James chapter 3. In verse 1. My brethren, let not many of you become teachers, knowing that we shall receive a stricter judgment. For we all stumble in many things. If anyone does not stumble in word, he's a perfect man, able to bridle the whole body. Indeed, we put bits in horses' mouths that they may obey us, and we turn their whole body. Look also at ships. Although they are large and are driven by fierce winds, they are turned by a very small rudder, wherever the pilot desires. Even so, the tongue is a little member and boasts great things. See how great a forest a little fire kindles. And the tongue is a fire, a world of what? Iniquity. The tongue is so set among our members that it defiles the whole body. How many of y'all know what you speak can defile you? Amen. And sets on fire the course of nature. And it is set on fire by what? By hell. For every kind of beast and bird, of reptile and creature of the sea is tamed and has been tamed by mankind. But no man can tame the tongue. It is an unruly evil, full of deadly poison. With it we bless our God and Father, and with it we curse men who have been made in the similitude of God. Out of the mouth, out of the same mouth proceed blessings and curses. My brethren, these things ought not to be so. See, but you will have dominion by the power of the Holy Spirit. Because you're going to know who's telling you that. Amen? You're going to go, who told me that before I speak it? The tongue. Psalm 1. Not someone, Psalm 1. Glory. Psalm 1. Let's speak it together, please. Is everybody there? Psalm 1. The undefiled. We are entering a new season. Undefiled. Blessed is the what? Is the man who walks not in the counsel of the godly, ungodly. So curses the man who does, right? Please. It's amazing how many people go back into fellowship and call and get counsel from somebody that's out there. They're living in fornication. They're lying. They're not in fellowship. And they want to get counsel from them. You know what they're doing? They're looking because their ears are itching. They want to get someone to approve what God disapproves of. So they figure if they can get the person to approve it, then God must approve it. But that's a lie. It's called deception. Amen? Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the truth or the law of the Lord. And in his law he meditates day and night. Again, he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth its fruit in its season, whose leaf also shall never wither. And whatever he does shall what? Whatever he does shall what? Prosper. But the ungodly, the rebellious are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind drives away. Therefore the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment or the reward, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous ones, but the way of the ungodly shall what? They shall what?
Perish.
In Jude. Jude. Is everybody there? Praise God. Glory. Thank you. Wow. Let's start at verse 11. Woe. W-O-E. without eternity. Woe to them, for they have gone in the way of Cain, who have run greedily in the ear of Balaam for profit and perished in the rebellion of Korah. These are spots in your love feast while they feast with you without fear, serving only who? Themselves. They are clouds without water carried about by the winds, late autumn trees without fruit, twice dead, pulled up by the roots, raging waves of the sea, foaming up in their own shame, wandering stars for whom is reserved the blackness of darkness forever. Now Enoch in the seventh from heaven prophesied about these men also, saying, behold, the Lord comes with 10,000 of his saints to do what? To execute on all, to convict all who are ungodly among them of their ungodly deeds which they have committed to an ungodly way, and of the harsh things which ungodly sinners have spoken against the Lord. These are what? Grumblers and complainers, walking according to their own lusts. They mouth great swelling words, flattering people to gain advantage. But you, beloved, remember the words which were spoken before by the apostles of our Lord Jesus Christ, and how they told you that there would be what? Mockers in the last time, who would walk according to what? Their own ungodly lusts. These are sensual persons who cause divisions. Why? Because they don't have the Spirit. They're not empowered by the Holy Spirit. Has everybody got it? The undefiled. I'm going to close it. Revelation 3. Maybe we need to do a shirt that says the undefiled. It's like the untouchables, you know. Can't touch this. We'll put on the back, the undefiled, can't touch this. I like that. Write that down, Viv. Glory! Are you blessed?
Yes.
Amen. Isn't it a wonderful thing to know truth?
Amen.
See, but not only know it, you must love it. You must love truth. Everything in your life should say, I want to know the truth. I want to know the truth. No, I'm not expecting that. I want to know the truth. See, because when you give up your last breath, it's too late. Everyone in hell is a believer. They're believers now, aren't they? Amen. Let me tell you, you enter hell, you become a believer. The problem is you can't get out. Revelation 3:1. And to the angel of the church in Sardis, write, what? These things says he who has the seven spirits of God and the seven stars. I know your works, that you have a name, that you are alive, but you are what? Dead. Nice. Be watchful and strengthen the things which remain that are ready to die, for I have not found your works perfect before God. Remember, therefore, how you have received and heard. Hold fast and do what? Repent. Therefore, if you will not watch, I will come upon you as a thief. And you will not know what hour I will come upon you. Now, he's talking about you as individuals. To do what? Take your last breath. You have a few names, even in Sardis, who have not what? Who have not what? Defiled their garments. And they shall walk with me in white, for they are what? Worthy. The undefiled walk with him. Because they're worthy. Ooh. Verse 5. He who overcomes shall be clothed in white garments, and I will not blot out his name from the book of life. But I will confess his name before my Father and before his angels. He who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the churches. And we have a message already given to us from the church, to the church, to this body, by the Lord. 2017 is going to be dangerous but glorious. Exposure. Get ready. Amen. Amen. Father, we give you all the glory, honor, and praise, and we thank you. We thank you. And Lord, if there's anything that is defiling in our life, we ask that you expose it and remove it, that we may be counted among the undefiled, worthy in relationship, in service, and battle unto our King. Prepare our hearts this morning for communion and keep our eyes open to you. Expose and remove, that we may be washed by the blood and cleansed and called the undefiled in Jesus' name. You may bring your offerings up and prepare your heart for communion.